Tonight I just want to deal with the spirit of fear. I want to deal with the spirit of fear. Fear, fear. A lot of people are going through fear. A lot of people are going through the bondage of fear. And God doesn't want you and I to be under the spirit of fear. God doesn't want to see you afraid. And when we talk about being afraid, one time I went to a prophetic conference and the man of God was dealing with fear. And he was saying that there was somebody here in our midst who is very afraid. So the least one person I was expecting to stand up was a man who was as tall as Shaq O'Neal. Shaq, the basketball player. How tall is he?
I think he's almost 7 foot.
Almost 7 foot.
I think he might be six.
And this man was that big, very tall, very huge guy. And then he rose up. As big as he was, as tall as he was. In fact, if I'm standing by him, I don't look like a man. That was how huge and how powerful this man is. However, this man was being tormented by the spirit of fear. He was tall, he was huge, he was a giant to look upon, but he was afraid. And do you know why he was afraid? Because the fear was tormenting him. Because in his family, nobody lives above 45. Everybody who get to the age of 40, 43, 44, 45, you have to die. And he was now around his 40s. So constantly, the devil was tormenting him with a spirit of fear. Huge as he was, but he was afraid. So sometimes, somebody may be going around and you never know what is causing them to be afraid. And the devil knows how to keep you and I in fear and torment. Today, I just don't want to deal with the fear factor, but I want to deal with the fear that brings about crippling and also tormenting. That is what the devil is using to destroy a lot of people. Fear, which generates crippling effect and also tormenting. When you are tormented by the spirit of fear, precious one, you cannot sleep. You cannot sleep. Insomnia, you have to take tablets before you can sleep. Because there is something which will be tormenting you and nobody seems to know how to help you. Every day I use this example that as much as Michael Jackson was preparing himself for This Is It, and the world was expecting him to come to on stage to do great things. But doing that at the same time, he couldn't sleep without taking medication. And he was almost paying his doctor almost $120,000 a month just so that the doctor would constantly be with him to give him sleeping pills. Torment. A lot of people, even can be CEOs and big time people, you see them in the next day laughing, but fear is bringing torment. And that tormenting demon is depriving them the joy and peace that they need to enjoy in life. The crippling and the tormenting demon that comes as a result of fear. And the devil knows how to cripple you. The crippling is that the devil can let you be so afraid in life that you may not take a step of faith to possess that which belongs to you. Many of us are so much afraid of something. Maybe in the past you failed an exam. Maybe in the past you failed something. And therefore, the devil has caused fear to grip you. God is saying that, son, you can do it. Go for it and possess your possession. Just like the children of Israel, God promised them that go forth and possess the promised land. And yesterday the Bible said that Moses sent out 12 spies to go and scout out the land. When they went, 10 came back with the crippling effect that we saw giant, we cannot do it. We are so terrified about the giant. God cannot deliver us from this giant. Only Joshua and Caleb, the Bible says, had a different spirit. They were the only ones who had faith, which was able to overcome the fear and the crippling effect. The other 12 rebelled, disobeyed, and none of them went to the promised land. Fear can cripple you from fulfilling your destiny on earth. Fear. Elijah had seen great move of God by calling fire from heaven to come upon the altar. Everybody was now jubilating that the God of Elijah was our God. One word from a woman, Jezebel, crippled Elijah. Somebody God did a great thing in his life that he was able to slay almost 400 prophets. That same day that he was enjoying his victory, the devil released one word of fear into his heart. And this prophet was running away from a woman. She's just sent a letter saying that prepare to die. And if God had given this great man of God power to kill prophet Balaam, prophet of Balaam, and he has seen fire come from heaven, he should have been able to say, who is this woman to threaten me? But fear gripped him. And now he was running away from this woman and was telling the Lord, Lord, I want to die. I want to die. I want you to take me off the scene. I can't do this anymore. Even in your peak, in your height, the devil can still place a fear. And fear will cause you to abort your destiny. People's destiny are aborted because of fear. Fear is something you and I have to deal with. Otherwise, it will cripple you from the best of God for you. And also cause you to be under constant torment. Every day that you are about to move forward, advance, fulfill God's ultimate purpose for your life, that tormenting demon, that crippling demon will tell you, you can't do it. You can't do it. You can't do it. If you do it, you'll fail. Don't you remember your past? Don't you remember? And that will always keep you bound. When one is crippled, that person cannot move. So you can enter into a year, and that spirit of fear and that crippling and tormenting effect can cripple you so that you stay one spot and see the whole year, months, weeks, days go by without doing nothing. Because anytime you're about to make a move, you are afraid. 2012, when I tried, I failed it. 2012, when I tried, I didn't succeed. This year too, I don't want to fail again. How will I? And then you don't move. Fear is the opposite of faith. God wants you and I to operate by faith and not by fear. God wants you to operate by faith in Him, not by fear. Because now the world is under the bondage of the enemy. And because we are going through recession, we are going through tough times economically and chaos all around us, a lot of people are so afraid. Some people are working and they are just afraid of losing jobs. What if they fire me tomorrow? How am I going to pay my mortgage, my car loan, take care of my family? What am I going to do? They have a job, but the devil is just tormenting them. You are going to lose a job. You are going to lose your job. If you lose your job, how are you going to make it? They have a job, but the fear of losing a job is still denying them the enjoyment of saying, Lord, I thank you for this present job. They are under constant torment. So at their workplace, they are always finding themselves vulnerable. Vulnerable because they cannot have peace to function right. Always there's that fear. If I lose my job, how will I settle the bills? Fear is tormenting people. And if you don't have a job, Lord, will I ever find one? I'm looking for a job. I'm not finding one. How is it going to work? Fear, tormenting and crippling people from becoming all that God has for them. If you want to overcome fear, you and I have to have faith. And your faith shouldn't be in you, but should be in God. I always give this example that David, when he came on the scene, Saul and all the Israelites, they were a lot, had an army with him. But because Goliath, one giant, was constantly tormenting them with fear, none of them ever tried to even go and fight the giant. But when David came on the scene, he said that, who is this uncircumcised Philistine defiling the army of God? I know my Redeemer. I know I have a God who can never fail me. So I'm going to fight this giant. I'm not going to fight him with swords and spears and with all this ammunition. I'm just going to go in the name of the Lord of hosts. And David was able to bring down the giant. This year, whatever is causing fear and torment and crippling effect in your life, if you and I will take our eyes off the issue, off the problem, off the challenge that you are going through, God will give you victory over that situation. If you walk in fear, you will be crippled. You will never be able to cross over, to take over. You will never be able to overcome any temptation, any trial, and any challenge that you go through. It will always overcome you because you are operating under fear. The devil knows when you are afraid. And when you are afraid, he takes advantage of your ignorance of operating in fear, and he holds you in bondage. For the Bible says that without faith, it is impossible to please God. So you and I cannot please God and see the miracle of God and see the power of God at work in our lives unless we begin to walk in faith and not fear. Today I ask you, what is it that is crippling you, causing you to have sleepless nights, causing you to be paranoid, causing you to be fearful and anxious, causing you to be stressful, causing you to say to yourself that I'm inferior, I think I can't do it? What is it that is causing you to be afraid? God hasn't given you the spirit of fear. God hasn't given you the spirit of fear, and God doesn't want you to be under constant fear and torment.